Imagine a new internet where you own your data, transactions are transparent, and middlemen are obsolete. Welcome to the world of Web3, where it's completely changing the game when it comes to a decentralized digital future. This is not financial advice, I'm not a financial advisor, but today we're going to be talking about three projects that I think have massive potential this bull run. So what exactly is Web3? Well, to understand that, we have to understand what Web1 and Web2 are, and that is actually fairly simple. So Web1 was basically just text on a web page, no real graphics, a couple color variation, stuff like this, but really just a notepad and an information log. Then we have Web2. This is where things got a lot more media-centric and content began to be based around social media. However, the problem with this is it was very centralized, and yes, it's something that you cannot control, you do not own your data, and there are many problems with Web2 as it is right now. But this is where Web3 comes along. Web3 is essentially all about crypto and decentralization, where you will own everything that you have on the internet, whether that's your data for your accounts, whether that's your assets, or whether that is maybe your game accounts on, say, Gala Games or something like this. Web3 is really decentralized data and transactions between digital wallets on blockchains. And a lot of people in crypto believe this is the future of the internet. So let's dive into three projects that I think have massive potential to bring Web3 to the mainstream and change the internet forever. First up, we have the Sui Network. This is a layer one blockchain that basically allows anyone to build, whether it's GameFi, whether it's AI, but they have a very cool onboarding system, which essentially allows anyone to interact with these Web3 apps, but without the need for a crypto wallet, without the need for transferring crypto in, without the need for all of the jargon that a lot of the crypto space holds that really just limits the mainstream to getting involved. But this is an amazing blockchain. It's worth tens of billions of dollars, and we can see that they are backed by a lot of different companies and partnered with a lot of big corporations. So this is something that is huge, and as you can see, total value locked at $2 billion on this chain alone. So this is something that, yes, people can come over, they can build on it, but there's no limit to how much the mainstream can enjoy it because there's no complications when it comes to the onboarding process. As you can see here, players own assets, creators manage royalties. So there's a royalty function here where if you are a dev and you create a game, you can actually use this blockchain to earn directly inside with it being crypto. On the commerce side, you can see increased customer engagement and loyalty for less. This essentially takes Sui's composable assets and allows users to authenticate with web credentials to reduce friction. Again, just bringing the onboarding process back to Web2, where people can actually get involved with it very easily. Then there is the DeFi side. So DeFi on Sui is massive. There is so much locked up on Sui, as we saw, $2 billion, and I do think it has the potential to scale even more. So overall, Sui is with less code, it's more secure, easier for devs, easier for retail to get involved. And overall, as a blockchain, it has absolutely been flying in the past couple years. That's why in 2025, I think this is going to absolutely explode even more. Next, we have Metabox Labs, and these guys focus on decentralized connectivity and location-based services. What this means is you could essentially go into your local business or have your own business, use this product to essentially reward customers for connecting to your Wi-Fi. This is going to give your customers points, potentially gift codes, perks, and other bonuses. What this does, it uses an app to essentially collect location data and then use that data to enhance the business and enhance the customer's experience. With this premium Wi-Fi feature, any kind of client or merchant doesn't need to switch internet providers. They literally just have to get the app and they have to set it up, and it's as simple as that from that point. Both the user and the merchant can earn from this. And this is using blockchain technology to really enhance that experience. From the user's perspective, you can see the rewards app would look something like this. You collect enough rewards by connecting to various businesses, whether you're in your local coffee shop, whether you are out for dinner, right? All you gotta do is connect to the Wi-Fi and you are going to be rewarded for that. This is going to be great for businesses to actually sell gift codes to bring those customers back, but it's also great for the user because they're going out to eat anyway, or they're going out to get coffee, so they can actually earn extra rewards for doing that, allowing them to basically get discounts and stuff like this from their normal day-to-day experiences. And that is Metabox Labs, definitely something that is using the blockchain for something in the real world, allowing retail to earn as well as merchants to benefit from extra customers. Fantastic stuff from Metabox. Let's move on to the final project. The final project here is the Immutable Passport. This essentially allows Web3 gamers to set up in this system and then sign into any game in the blockchain space really with ease, right? It's literally as simple as signing in with Google, but allowing Web3 to essentially generate the wallet for you and have everything ready in a non-custodial wallet that's simple and easy for retail to understand. As you can see here, simple sign-on similar to anything with social media platforms. Just sign in with Immutable. If you have an Immutable account, you can get onto that game very, very easy. And the way this thing works is so scalable and so easy for any Web3 game to implement this that it's going to help the Immutable project just grow fantastically. And it could be really the stamp or the staple for social media. And it could really be the stamp or the staple for social media in the Web3 gaming space. This doesn't just allow the gamers to sign into the game, but it also allows for marketplaces that potentially sell NFTs, stuff like this, to actually have a login system that allows people to connect with this instead of their wallet. That way, if any new projects or new marketplaces are trying to get trust, then they implement this and then people can sign in very easily without having the risk of getting their wallet drained or something like this. In terms of security, having this one-stop shop for signing in is massive for the Web3 space and a huge innovation. But you can imagine this actually scaling into the real world as well, potentially new rising social media platforms such as Rumble, such as other platforms out there could potentially implement this, allowing this sign-in feature, allowing this passport in the Web3 space to come over to the Web2 space and enhance everything in an entire closed system. So that is the three projects here. We have Sui for basically development and easy user onboarding. Then we have Metabox, which allows businesses and customers to thrive from retail in real life engagements. And we have Immutable, which really just allows people to sign in and have everything in one place when it comes to their crypto. That's going to be it for this video. Let me know what you think of these three projects. I think they are revolutionary, and I think they will massively change Web3 space. And that will be the end of the video. Have a fantastic day. I will see you in the next one.